Dear mama, I'm not gonna wait until your death for a man to celebrate your breathing the way that I do. You carried burdens across glass lips without breaking a smile, gave birth to a whole child while spoon-feeding the egos of men that couldn't step up to the plate with their own colors. When I used to wipe your tears, you told me to remain strong because you knew you had no man to rely on to shift the pounds of stress that was weighing down your discouragement. And even though I was too young to understand why you were dying within, that never stopped me from trying to live up to the expectations of manhood that wanted to protect its mother, but I was just too boy, so I fell short. It hurt me to see that love only came by way of conditional commitment, where waves of emotion sickness were too frequent to ignore. You developed a chronic condition because loyalty was unavailable to provide healing for years of your vulnerability being exposed to maltreatment you didn't deserve. I hated seeing you chase after men that took your advantage, running towards shame because to them, deserting women was sweeter than becoming fluent in intimacy. You worked so damn hard, and you were never given the opportunity to clock out of your strength to be pampered by a man who was willing to give the bags under your eyes that carry overtime a day off just to feel what it's like to be loved sometime. You never made excuses even when you felt the pain of arthritis tattooed to your knuckles from pushing against hardship that tried to strangle the life out of your self-worth. You were always first to say I love you. As a reminder to never forget where the sound of home travels from while the men in your life drifted away at war within their own manhood. Mama, I appreciate you for all that you've endured. Always being asked to do more or be less. Give love but less strength. More sex but less intense. Be everything but not too much. Short but don't shine. Ain't nobody got time for that. You've always been my light that illuminates that crossroads. And you've earned everything that intersects with your personality. Your blackness, your feminine and masculine energy. Your love, your grace, your tenacity. I look up to you, mama. So never lean your chin down to think about stepping off of your throne. The ground isn't clean enough to be worthy of your steps. It's because of you I cherish the black that every woman stands on. I appreciate you, mama. For all that you've done, the sacrifices you've made, the scars that remain that stem from your stomach like varicose veins, I'm the birthmark that branded you with this inscription. Those marks have nurtured my eyes to see life through the lens of mothers who've carried melanin bodies in the darkest corners of their wombs manifestation. Black mothers, I appreciate you for the cause that played through the empathy of your voice, through the encouragement carrying our ancestors on your tongue, through the soft whispers of your touch that can calm the uneasiness on my skin. Black mothers, I appreciate you. I see your beauty in the molasses covering your bones, in the comfort stored in the fullness of your lips, in the ocean current that waves and curls through your locks and through your soul that's carried in each one of your strides. You are nature's personification in the female form, and I'm just a byproduct of your perfection. A black woman who's curated my anatomy and clothed me with the origin that drips all over my flesh. So how could I not honor you? How could I be the fool that doesn't love you? You are the matriarch of my blackness. Without you, there is no life. You are the author of my beginning. Without you, I don't breathe. Your signature runs through every word that I utter. I am a black man because I came from a black mother. I didn't stutter. I said that I am a black man because I came from a black mother, so let me be clear. You are the flower that grew out the concrete that still managed to produce enough nectar sweet enough to love your soul child, despite the world trying to trample all over your ebony. And for that, I will do whatever it takes to preserve your essence. I will be your servant, ministering your word, and you will forever be the world's gift and not be forgotten. I will always be the ultrasound to your heartbeat's music that continues to teach me how to love. Black mother.